Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Luke Ness Monster. Today we have some very exciting TVC and Black Series news to go over. We actually got three brand new reveals for Bring Home the Bounty. Every Tuesday, of course, we get some product reveals. We got some banger reveals today. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. Real quick though, if you're not subscribed, make sure to hit that sub button because we're actually doing a giveaway at 5,000 subscribers. We're giving away this ARC Trooper Echo. It is sealed and ready to ship once we hit 5K. And guys, we are so freaking close to 5K. We're like 350 subs away, which is absolutely amazing. So if you guys are not subscribed, please consider hitting that sub button. It means the world to me. And I really think we can get to 5K before the new year. I think we can get there before January 1st. So I'm setting that goal on the channel. Let's hit 5K before January 1st. If you're not subbed, hit that sub button. You do have to be subbed to enter the giveaway, like I said. So hit that sub button and on to the news. So yeah, TVC fans today lucked out because they actually got two brand new figure reveals, and then Black Series got a helmet reveal, which is also freaking amazing. But we're going to start off with TVC. First up is the TVC Fennec Shand. This figure looks really, really good. Is it as good as the Black Series figure? I think, you know, some TVC figures look better than the Black Series figures, and some Black Series looks better than TVC, but honestly, I think that Black Series is going to take the cake on this one. I just think the whole photo reel on TVC on this guy just does not look super good. It almost looks more like a man than it does a woman, which I know sounds kind of weird, but it just doesn't look like the actress, so I don't know. I think the rest of the figure looks absolutely amazing. She, of course, does come with her two blasters. And then she also does come with, like, the blue bottle container thing that she was holding at the end of Mandalorian in, like, the post-credit scene, I guess you could say, of the last episode of Mandalorian. And, yeah, so I'm so glad they included that in this figure. And I really hope they I guess, find a way to include that in a future Black Series figure, but it would have been really nice to get that in the Black Series 6-inch scale, but it is what it is. I'm just glad TVC is including it, because this figure does look incredible. And then TVC Boba Fett from Book of Boba Fett also got revealed, and he is a deluxe figure. This guy does come with a ton of accessories, and he is the accurate version of Boba Fett that'll show up in the show, which is incredible. Like I was saying earlier, some TVC figures do it better than Black Series, and some Black Series do better than TVC, and this is one where TVC totally just knocks Black Series out of the park, because this TVC figure looks incredible. It is the, you know, actual accurate version of the armor to the show, whereas the Black Series one, it has super poofy like pants, it has blue like leg warmer shin guards when they should be red, and it doesn't have near enough weathering. So the Black Series version is actually the one from the Mandalorian post credit scene, and they just threw it in the Book of Boba packaging, which is kind of a shame. I really wish they would have went ahead and did the actual like Book of Boba figure, or they should have put this figure in the Mandalorian packaging. Either way, I would have been fine with that, but them throwing this figure in the Book of Boba Fett packaging just doesn't work. The only way that this really works is if this version of Boba Fett does show up in the Book of Boba Fett TV show, so we will find that out once the show airs, but if I had to guess, he's gonna have a brand new outfit, and that brand new outfit is the one that TVC just revealed, which does look incredible. Anyway, I did get a little sidetracked there, but the TVC version does look incredible. It does come with two Remnant Stormtrooper / Sand Trooper helmets, which are pretty cool. I mean, it's cool to always have extra helmets, I guess, but Boba here does have two blasters. He comes with a removable helmet with the amazing Temuera Morrison face underneath. Then he also does come with three blast effects, two for his jetpack, and then one for the rocket on his jetpack, which is removable. So if you want to have it like he's shooting the rocket out of his backpack, you can, which is super cool. And I really wish that's something they would have done with Black Series. They completely missed an opportunity there. And yeah, TVC is knocking it out of the park. Biggest problem, though, is the figure's price. This guy is $26.49 retail, which is very expensive for a TVC figure. While it is a deluxe figure, it doesn't come with near enough accessories to warrant that price, I would think. If you compare this to some of the recent TVC figures revealed, like the Stormtrooper and Artillery Blaster, this thing was cheaper than $26 and came with more plastic, I think you could argue, with that huge E-Web turret. So, yeah, $26 is a lot of money for a TVC figure. I mean, considering the Black Series version is $31, like $29, something like that. So, yeah, it is it's a big price, and I think it looks great, though. And plus, this exclusive packaging looks incredible, too. I absolutely love their new deluxe-style packaging. It looks incredible, so Yeah, good for you guys, TVC. And the Black Series today also did get a brand new helmet, which looks so freaking dope. This is one of the best helmets we've gotten in a long, long time. Most of the time recently, they've just been like repaints of an X-Wing helmet or a Stormtrooper helmet. But this one looks incredible. It is actually Bo-Katan's helmet, which is awesome. I absolutely love it. So I know they're going to reuse this helmet mold as many times as possible. I think if you change a few pieces in it, you could reuse it as a Cosca Reeves helmet. You could reuse it as a Sabine helmet. You could use it several times. You could use it as some other random Mandalorian from Rebels or Clone Wars. I think you could use it quite a few times, and I really hope they do, because I'm in love with this helmet. Like, I want to buy it just to have it on the shelf, because, I mean, I'm not female, so I can't really wear it. I mean, I guess I could wear it, but I mean, I wouldn't really make any sense. But I honestly just want to buy it to put it on a shelf, because it does look that freaking awesome. I love them doing helmets like this, but come on, Hasbro, make some Clone Trooper helmets. I think fans have been asking for Clone Trooper helmets for a long time now. Obviously, Hasbro knows that the fans love clones, and just the amount of repaintability a Clone Trooper helmet has, too. Obviously, they're repainting the Stormtrooper helmet 5, 6, 7 times, when they could easily repaint a Clone Trooper helmet as many times as they wanted to, and I don't think anybody would bat an eye or get upset just because of how much people love these Clone Troopers. So, yeah, please make a Clone Trooper helmet. That's all I really have to say about that. But yeah, we also do have some exciting news coming up in tomorrow's news video, so if you guys do want some more news, stay tuned for tomorrow. I will release that then, but for now, that is going to do it for this video. I did just want to cover all the new recently revealed products. Hit the like button and subscribe if you're new to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video.